Hello everyone, and welcome back to my Let's Play World Series 2. Let's see, last time we talked about the hotels I built here. And I think I've been watching these houses for a while, and you can see all the doors are open. I opened them all just to see if the villagers would actually use them, and they do not. They only use the hotels now, so I think I'm going to remove those houses and put in another hotel over there somewhere. I don't know where yet. So yes, let's see, since last time I've been live streaming for the first time ever the other day for 4.5 hours, which was a lot of fun. I made a what's it called, a hardcore world. And the people that who were there came up with challenges for me. The first one was to bake a cake, and I did that. Then I found a skelly spawner, and I turned that into two different kinds of traps while we were live streaming. And I then found, I went to the Nether and found a, what's it called, a stronghold. And yeah, the episode kind of, or the live streaming kind of ended down there. So, but it was over on Twitch TV. So if you go to twitch.tv/dk, you can follow me when I live stream. There's a little button you can push apparently where you can follow me, and you'll get a notification whenever I live stream. And Twitch.tv also records your live stream, so there's a file over there. I made a link to it in my feed on my channel on YouTube. It's a 4-hour video file of the live stream, so if you're really bored, you can go take a look at that. So yeah, something else happened which I'm very happy about, and that is I got my first donation. Yay! First donation, woo! And it was from Tobias S for $5 today. So thank you very much, Tobias. I'm very happy. I built this little building here for you, and I put a dog in here for you. This is your dog now. If you would rather have a cat, or a snowman, or a sheep, or a pig, or a chicken or cow, I can put that in there instead. I may have to remodel this a little bit, but don't worry about that. If you would rather I build it out of some other material, you let me know and I will do that. But for now, this is how I'm gonna thank you. I built this little house here for your dog, and I put a sign up with your first name and the first letter in your last name. I don't know your YouTube channel. If you have one and you want it linked, I can put it on here in the spare line. So you just PM me and tell me, okay? So that's nice. I'm always happy. This is the first time I got a donation, so I'm very happy. But I'm always happy when people see my stuff and like it. And I'm guessing that Tobias watches my stuff and likes it, so that makes me happy. And if you want to donate to me, you can do that. There's a link on my YouTube page. I haven't talked about this before. I just put it up there a while back, because I don't want to force anyone into doing anything. You don't have to feel like you need to do it at all. If you can spare the money and you like my content, feel free to do so. But if you don't have the money or you don't feel like giving out any, that's okay too. You don't have to. I'm happy for anything. Even if you just watch my videos and like the content, or if you learn something, that's fine. So, this is the first time I got a donation, and that's why I mentioned it today. Okay, this is my new, what these called, reed farm, sugarcane farm, by the way. I just put up over here. I didn't want to have it over there I have a little one in that glass thing there, underneath the mob thingy, where I get a few reeds now and then, but I just put the reeds all around this little lake over here, so that's fine. Let's see, last time we built the crusher down by the zombies, and I think we should go there and take a look. I actually got it done, I got it working. So let's run down there. It's a short run. And some of you guys who have been with me for a while know that it's very unusual for me not to eat bread, but I'm actually on chicken at the moment. So yeah, I just thought I wanted to try something new, so now I eat chicken. Because I have it this way, what I mean is because I have these pistons in like this, I can't really hide this redstone here. But what I did, you saw last time, I just put up this out here. And of course I can't get out now, thank you. And I figured out the exact length I needed, and then I made a hole here. So if any mobs should spawn over there or over there, they can't get past this, unless they're spiders, of course. And the same over here. So they can't actually get in here to this area with all the redstone and ruin it. Well, they may fall down from up there, but I'm not gonna be back here, so I hope that's not gonna be the case. So when I push this button, this extract pushes out for the right amount of time, so I can get them all down to 2 or 3 hits. I don't take them down to one because some of them take a little bit of damage in there or somewhere along the lines, and I just throw a potion at them. So if they had 1 hit point or 2 or 3 left, it doesn't matter, they all die anyway. And I'm on peaceful. Oh, sorry about that. I was on the test world earlier. So yeah, I've done something else too, and we're gonna take a look at that now. Yes. Well, you saw that last time. I know we're not gonna do that again. I made a new bow, by the way, and I was very lucky. Power 5, flame, and punch. I haven't actually used it yet because the other one just ran out yesterday, I think. So I've had this in the chest for a few days, and now finally I can start using it. So let's take a sleep here. And try it out on these. Oh well, there's no really need to use it on these guys over here. These should be pretty easy to kill. Excuse me. Let's see the chicken. I haven't done anything else up here, I think. No. I finished the farm for the what are they called? The zombies down there. And I have been in the Nether. So I will show you what I have done. I don't know if you've seen this. This is my Nether wart farm I have growing all along here. This is just in my spawning place I encased in this netherrack. There's a way to get out there if I just remove a few of these. And I set up a little chicken farm here. So if I run out of food, I can always roast some chicken. And also, it's nice to have, well, some kind of animals around. And this is the road I built over to the fortress I found after having searched for it for a long time. I was unlucky in my spawning area when I got to the Nether that there was no Nether fortress for miles around. So the road over to the Nether fortress is actually pretty long and winding and goes up and down quite a lot. So we're gonna run over there and take a look. But I've tried to make a safe way to get over there. Oh, and we get some nice lag here. Okay. Thank you for that, Minecraft. Damn pigmen. Kill me. Bastards. Yeah. Oh well, I'm not gonna tell what I meant about that, but some of you know. So we are almost there now. I don't know if you remember when I came to the Nether Fortress over here, I put up these markers. These first to show me the way out, and then these to show me the way to the nearest blaze farm. But if I follow them around, I can go this way, and then go along this, and then down here. Or, well, this is actually in my way now. No, let's get rid of that. I'm gonna put that there. I also made a way out here first, so I can get back easier. And I made an enchantment room here, and you probably know why by now. Because I have made one of these. Yeah, that's a blaze spawner in there. And this is just the standard piston mobby evader thingy. So they spawn, they land on the pressure pads, they get pushed out and fall down until they end in a 1x2 area way down there. As you may see. And I actually found out when I removed this wall, I found out, oh wait, I'm right here at the entrance. So this was actually right here when I entered the Nether Fortress. So that's very nice. And the way it works is I go down this staircase here. And I just stand here. And let them spawn and come down here. Let's just turn the sound down on these guys. And I can keep count. Approximately there's about 10 in there now. There might be a few pigmen on the other side too that gets counted, but that's okay. So I wait till I have a good number in there. Then I have this lever here. Pushes out, see if I use it. You see those two blocks there and there got pushed out. So the next places cannot enter the area. Now they can fall down and join the others. So this is just the standard crusher setup. When I push this, blocks here on the sides get pushed out. We let these guys come down and then I can demonstrate. So, come on in guys, the water's fine. Yes, thank you. We close that and we press this. And these two blocks, that one and that one, come in at the head level and one above if they should be jumping at the moment they close. And they get them down to one hit, as you can see. So I just stand here and hit kill them like this. And I get a lot of XP. Because blazes, whoops, is the best mob in the game for XP. All other hostile mobs give you 5 XP, but blazes give you 10. So there, I opened that up, and the newly spawned blazes can come down here to this area again. So the way I made this, back here, I have, this is the other side of the blaze area. They are right on the other side of this wall here. Over here behind this torch I have the lever to open and close the gate to let them in here. And this goes down and over to the other side and up this to this piston which is behind there. There's nothing behind here. This is just a block to put the power down to the top piston. I have three pistons on top of each other here. And when I pull the lever, only the top one, the one in there, actually extends. I don't know if I can open. Yeah. So you can see this piston here gets extended when I pull the lever to stop any more blazes from coming down. And the signal goes below where I'm standing and comes out on the other side over here. I'll show you. Comes out here, which is below this floor, and goes the same way up and to the same. I have three pistons in here. There, there, and there. And the block goes, the power goes to this, those two blocks over up there via just redstone in this case. And the crusher pistons that go here, that's a two lower one, gets controlled by this button. We can go look at the button, which is back here. It's right behind this block, this one, and when I push it, this redstone wire here gets lit up and go into this RS knowledge and turns on this torch. This torch then sends power directly to the two bottom pistons. As you can see here, it goes out. We can follow this one, this is easier. It goes this way and up and through these two pistons. So they start crushing. The other one goes on top of this, down over here, and through these two pistons. Next to that, the signal also goes to this line here of repeaters. It goes this way and all the way over here, and around and back and underneath this, and back and into this block, which resets the RS knowledge and open the crushers again. And then you just fix the timing, just like the zombie thingy I made. This is exactly the same setup, just the redstone is a little bit different. So that's what I've been up to. I just one night I was sitting here listening to audiobooks and I thought, well, I might as well build something while I'm listening to this. So I found this and I figured out how close it was and I thought, I'm gonna make this into my XP trap because I was tired of the zombie one down there. It's not very fast, even though it is faster than my skeleton one. I have a skeleton trap as well. That's not a crusher trap, that's a drop trap. But these are the best XP next to if you actually go to the end, kill the dragon and make an end farm. Because they spawn so many and so fast back there down in the end. So yeah, this is what I've been up to. And I brought some diamonds down here and I built this room here just so I don't have to go back all the way, the long way back to enchant and then go back here and get more XP. So I just go in here and enchant. And all of these blocks in the ceiling, they are all crafting tables. So no matter where I look, I just look up at the ceiling and I can craft my tool. And yeah. So I made a little enchanting room in here. And I blocked this off so I don't get too many pigmen in here. And that's about it. You can see I've been here a while making new items. I made this new bow. I made some new picks and a few new swords, I think. I actually forget. Let's see what else. Yeah, I brought some fire-resistant potions for working on the thing down here. Some glass so I can see in what I'm doing here. So, yeah, that's it. Excuse me. I just had a major coughing fit. I'm sorry about that. Let's get some sound back. And we can fight some pigmen on our way out here. See if we live. Where are they? I thought there were so many of them when I went down here. Hello. Thank you. Let's get out of here. I know last time I talked about a new way to make a small and efficient tree farm, and I think we have time to go take a quick look at that before I end this episode. So I'm just gonna run back, see if I can find any more of these here pigmen. I can get some teeth for the potions. The healing potions. Oh, there's some here. Oh no, not now, lag. Come on. Oh, I wanna try out my new bow. Oh, that's very effective. Ow. Okay. I think it's nice they drop gold and armor and golden swords and that. But it was also nice in the olden days, so to speak, when you could actually get cooked pork chop from them. But this is nice too. Oh, that's nice. Jump me on the staircase. Come on. Bring it! What's this? Sharpness 5? Oh, that's nice too. Oh, here's one. You wanna play? Why can't I hit these guys? What do I have on? Crappy armor. Oh, what's this? Oh, a feather falling one. Okay. Nothing special. It's just level 1 in chance I put on my stuff. How do I get out of here? Okay, this way. Oh, I hear them. Run away! So, yeah, that was what I've been up to lately. Let's see, I have some of this, I can put that up there. I have a little cooked chicken down here, that's nice too. So, let's quickly go and have a look at the tree farm. No! Ow. Oh well. Oh, it's night time. I better go sleep. Go to sleep! No, how dare you! Look, it's so bright around here. Look at this. This is an invasion. I've never seen one of them like this before. Oh wow, there's a lot of zombies here. They're just gonna keep on coming, I guess. let's sleep, get the invasion over with. There's a skelly on the roof. And the game just froze, I think. I don't know what just happened. What is happening? This is happening more and more, and I don't understand what's going on. Oh, it's so annoying. I'm gonna restart my client, and then I'll be right back. Okay, so I quit Minecraft, closed the client, and start it again. I hope it fixes it. Yeah, I think all the zombies are dead, burned up in the sun. Okay, so let's go have a look at this new tree farm. You can make it as big or as little as you want to. It's not really a tree farm, it's just a fast way to harvest wood. I'm gonna show you over here, because I have saplings and stuffs over here. Over here, I think it's best to use these kind of saplings. Yes, yes, woof woof. So what I do is, we can make a very small one here. Let's just make a 3x3 one. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, let's do 7 or 8. Okay, and then go all the way around like this. Oops. You can use glass to do this top part here if you want to. This is just to make sure you don't get any tall trees. And then go down again in the middle. And then you just plant all the way around here. There. Take your bone meal. Go all the way around. And then take your axe and go all the way around. So this is a very effective way to get a lot of wood very fast. And you saw the reason I raised it up one is because I don't want to get the leaves in my face when I plant a tree. And you won't, that won't happen if you're down here when you plant. So then you just, well, you can just wait for these to fall down, or help them a little bit, get some more saplings and apples, of course. Otherwise, you can just, if you have plenty of saplings, you can just plant again. Because, no, that up there shouldn't actually be wood. And I'll come back to why that is at some other point. So, no, don't use wood and don't use dirt for that. The top cover there, that should be stone or glass or some other solid block, but not dirt and not wood. So yeah, it's a very efficient little tree farm. And I just wanted to share that with you. I'm gonna take it down again, because I have several wood farms already. I got one in here, which I had to redo a few times, which was very embarrassing, because I didn't think. I actually made it out of, this is now out of sandstone, but I made it out of wood blocks. I thought, oh, wow, this looks great, but then I forgot that if you have a wood block near, leaves won't decay. So whenever I took down all my trees, all the leaves would just stay behind because it was all made out of wood. So that was stupid. And yeah, but don't tell anyone. That never happened. Okay, and we got a little more wood here. That's nice. Some rotten flesh. That's good. We can go give some rotten flesh to some of my puppies. Hello, my puppies. Oh, you need to stand up. Yes, and you can have some rotten flesh as well. Okay, you sit down, you sit down. And for some reason, when the puppy gets born, it has very low health. So you need to, what's it called? You need to feed it right away. Get over here, you. Hello, you two, get over here. You and you. Okay, you sit. Puppy, get over here. Ah, stupid puppy. So much noise from all these animals. Yes, now you want it, eh? Good, you sit. Good. And I have some fish in here, so I can do the same with the cats. I have one dog that is out. He's kind of keeping an eye on the place. This is my top dog right here. He's called Dog. By the way, you know, to capture ocelots and turn them into cats, you need fish. And I don't know if you knew this, but if you fish when it's raining, your chances of catching something is much higher. So whenever it rains, I always I hurry back here to my two little ponds. I have it over in that box over there. I have a fishing pole or two, and then when it's raining, just stand here and fish, because then you catch many, many more fish. Okay, so that's it for this time. I hope you had fun, and I will see you next time. Take care. Bye.